He loves you. Hallelujah. Right now, I'm an empty vessel this morning, and I'm being filled with God's Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I worship you, Lord God. I praise you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You say, go. And I've just been thankful for what the Lord has been doing. it's just been so good. Have you been enjoying it? Nice weather. That's it. Just been nice, hasn't it? Praise the Lord. And I think we're going to have a lot more of that come out there. Praise the Lord for that. And this is barbecue season. How many have been barbecuing so far? Well, I see some hands back there. Barbecue season now. And so we're looking forward to doing a little bit more of that this year ourselves. Well, praise the Lord. I'm going to ask Brother Jeff. He's going to come and read the bulletin announcements today. And he's going to read scripture and receive the offer. Hey, Brother Jeff. Come on up, guys. God bless you. God have you.
Good to see you. Sunday school is being held in the adult classroom, if you'd like to attend. And May 7th, Sunday school is 9:45 and service is 11 o'clock. May the 10th, we have family training hour from 6:15 to 7:30. And don't forget, May 14th is Mother's Day. Bring your pictures if you haven't already got them all up there. Don't forget your mom. Prayer and church. Attention, Pastor Pruitt is looking for volunteers to work in the Sunday school and the youth ministries. Also, volunteer to do office work on Tuesday. If you're interested, talk to Pastor Pruitt or Pam. And the gospel instruction book, anyone can hold the helm when the sea is calm. If thou sink in the day of adversity, thy strength is small. From Proverbs 24:10. And speaking of volunteering for stuff, it's a good thing. It makes you feel good, and it pleases God. And I'm going to talk about that a little bit today. This is where I was at in my Bible reading, and I came across it, so I thought, well, I'm going to bring it to church. So in 1 Peter 5, verses 1 through 4. All right. 5. The elders who are among you, I exhort, flock of God which is among you, serving as overseers, not by compulsion, but willingly, not for dishonest gain, but eagerly, nor as being lords over those entrusted to you, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that does not fade away. It's good to serve the church, and you got to want to do it because you want to do it, or you want to please God, or you feel called to. Why am I doing this? Because I love doing it, and I'm hoping that you guys can get something out of it.
Amen.
You don't do it because you feel guilty, or you don't do it to gain something or make yourself look good, or to show, that's what he's saying, is to show authority over people, you know, of the church. You do it to be an example for the body. Be a good example for the flock. And then it says someday you'll receive your reward, your crown for it. Believe that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to ask the ushers to come on up and we'll prepare to take the offering.
Here comes the ushers.
Oh, cool.
Thank you.
He that toots his own horn runneth out his own battle. So that's what happens when I preach a lot and I forget to charge the battery up. And so nevertheless, I'll grab this microphone every day. And so anyway, I use cordless, and sometimes I forget that even though I'm cordless, it doesn't mean that the batteries charge up by themselves. How many batteries? So sometimes as pastor, I forget. So please, I give you my apologies today. But nevertheless, God is good. Amen? And I sure love the Lord today. How about you? Amen. Let us look at sources of comfort today. Because I believe one of the greatest sources of comfort today is God. How many believe?
Amen.
God is a wonderful source of comfort. And as we talk about it today, we're going to illustrate how this all works to the glory of God. And everything works to our good, the Bible says. And so we want to remember that today. Amen. Would you pray for me, though, as we begin this process today? Father, we thank you again. And I just enjoyed the worship today and enjoyed the Sunday school and enjoyed the practice and all these things we were part of today. And I just want to say thank you, Father, for letting us be together again in that wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Even though we have technicalities that will take place, humming and buzzing, but sometimes electronics do that. And we thank you, Lord, for finding that and relieving it for us. We appreciate it so very much. But God, we come to you now as we come to this special part of the service, bringing the Word of God. We praise the Lord. We pray to the Lord. And now we're going to shout to the Lord. Amen. And giving glorification. We thank the Lord for the Word of God. And because we need the Word of God in our life. And Father, I pray for every person today. I pray that God will have his hand upon them in that wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Let my heart become your heart. Let my eyes become your eyes. Let my mouth become your mouth, Lord, as I totally submit myself to thee and thy Holy Spirit. Where he said, it's not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. And Lord God, right now I pray that the Spirit will just work its way through each and every heart today. That the Spirit will touch each and every life. And that the Spirit will anoint each and every person, and anoint me as a vessel of the Lord, as God has ordained this time. I give God glory and God praise. I thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Sources of comfort are important for us today. As we continue, last time we talked about choices, how they affect our lives. But no doubt other things affect our lives as well. Oftentimes, as believers, we take so many things for granted because of all the daily burdens that weigh us down. We just don't see the benefits that God gives us because we're always weighed down with all the burdens. How many know what I'm talking about? We just don't see the benefits of the Lord. We see them. We know they're here. Aren't you glad that right now that your body, God created your body in his likeness. And guess what? He created your body to be the temple of the Lord. He created us, amen, that his Spirit can live in our lives, live in our hearts. And that is such a wonderful event to take place in our life to have God presence with inside of us. Can you say amen to that?
Amen.
And so I want you to realize we don't understand these benefits. Why? Because of our humanity. And I want you to understand that. Today we're going to speak about what sources of comfort that come only what from God. As we continue, number one, God comforts our hearts. We find in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 16, now our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God, even our Father, which have loved us, have given us everlasting consolation and good hope through grace. Comfort your hearts, the Bible says. Comfort your hearts. God wants to comfort our heart. He's a comforting spirit today. God wants to comfort us in a time of need, in a time of loss, even in a time of goodness. God still wants to comfort us. Can you say amen? I don't know about you, but I see all the negative things that are happening out there today, but I am so thankful for the good things. And the good things that you bring to this little church, can you say amen? Amen. You bring the goodness of God in your hearts. And this is so powerful and so wonderful thing to have. So the Bible says, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 17, comfort your hearts. You and I are to comfort ourselves with God's blessing, amen, with God's light in our hearts, and with God touching our hearts. I don't know about you. I need that type of comforting touch that only comes from God. I love that song, because He lives, I can face tomorrow. How about you? Can you say amen? Amen. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. And the other song I love, oh, He touched me. Oh, He touched me. And now I know. About forgot the last part. Help me out.
And oh, the joy that floods my soul.
Something happened. And now
continually. Physically, our hearts are an internal organ, but
spiritually it's referred to as our conscience. Only God can heal the believer's heart. Only God can restore the believer's conscience. Can you say, only God can change a wicked heart to good? Someone say amen or amen. Only God can help you and me when it comes to our heart. But let me tell you, there's ramifications with the heart. There's a spiritual, there's a physical outside of it. As we continue with what happened to mankind, it grieved God. As we talk about the spiritual heart of God, the consciousness of it. Genesis chapter 6, verse 6, and it repented the Lord that he made man on the earth. It grieved him at his heart. I don't know about you, but I put this over here. It is written, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Matthew chapter 5, verse 8. I want you to know it repented the Lord. It grieved him. It bothered him. He was distraught over it. As we continue, the grieving process mends the heart. The word grieving means he laid it over the people of the earth. He mourned for them like they had died. It grieved him so much that we, it's like we all died. Was so unsettling to him. That he regretted never making us. Because of our sinful nature. It's like you have a son and you place him on a pedestal. This is my son. This is, and all of a sudden your son, something terribly happens with him. Instead of being a son of honor, he goes out and steals a car, steals a truck, and the police catch him, and they arrest him. And when they arrest him, they bring him back to you. And all of a sudden you say, your son, why did you do this? Why did you steal that? When I gave you this one, which is so much nicer, so much better. Why did you break my heart? This is what happened to God. He saw that mankind's wickedness had prevailed. It disturbed him. Bible says in Genesis, but Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Everything was totally out of control. His watchers take women, the sons of God have taken women to be mortal, taken mortal women for wives. And then let the hybrid of giants begin. And the giants began to populate and begin to devour the creation that God set forth and gave to mankind. And God saw that everything was completely out of its balance, out of its order. Mankind was being destroyed, being manipulated by Satan and his followers. You remember the account with Adam and Eve. How many remember how Adam and Eve were deceived by the serpent? And how Satan manipulated them and corrupted mankind. And God saw Adam fall. And he saw all those after Adam fall. And he began to look at the wickedness of mankind and realize, wow, look what's happened to them. This is so disturbing. in order to correct it. The Bible says that Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. He said, mankind's life will only be 120 more years, and I will destroy everything and start over again. I believe during that 120-year cycle, he began to round up all the offenders. For the Bible speaks in the book of Jude that they are kept in a prison called Tartarus. And they've been gathered there and in prison because of their defilement of mankind. Now, let me tell you something. God has a way of straightening things up. Can you say amen?
Amen.
But I want you to know the grieving process. It mended his heart. He began to understand the sickness that was taking place. Not only began to understand, he always understood. But it bothered him. It began with Adam. His fall, then the rest of mankind began to fall into great wickedness. God's heart was broken because of us. It was broken. His heart was broken because of us. His heart was despaired. God became lame. God began to mourn. Like he lost his race. He lost his people.
Okay.
Who's you guys pray with me right now?
Yes.
There's the enemy is really trying to fight this today. Pray with me, oh God. We come to you right now. And we submit ourselves to you again. Help us, God. Help us overcome this. Help us do this, Lord. Help us receive this word of God. Help us to receive this today. Because the Bible says, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth from the mouth of God. When this tempter came, he said, if you're truly the Son of God, turn these stones into bread. And he rebuked him. He said, it's written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth from the mouth of God. Oh God, right now, let us eat of your word. Let us nourish on your word, oh God. Let us fill ourselves with your bread, the bread of heaven, oh God. Help us this day receive this bread into our life, oh God. Help us, Lord God, right now. Help us in Jesus' wonderful name. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor today. In Jesus' name again, we thank you. Amen. As we continue the second source is to love one another, John's Gospel, chapter 15, verse 12. This is my commandment that you love one another as I have loved you. John chapter 15, verse 13, greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. John 15, verse 17, these things I command you, that ye love one another as God loved us. We are to love one another. We are to what? Show kindness to one another. We're to encourage one another. Why? Because God loved us. Can you say it grieved him so much that we failed, but yet on the second part, he brought us back through his Son, Jesus Christ. Can you say amen? For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. Whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. God loved us so. Amen. The first Adam failed us, but he sent the second Adam, his name is Jesus Christ. Can you say amen? He sent the second Adam. His second Adam redeemed us and brought us what? Comfort. The second source, believe it or not, is Jesus. And he said, this is my commandment, that you love each other as I have loved you. He said, if you really love me, show each other respect. Be considerate of each other. Don't put each other down, but lift each other up. greatest command is love and not hate. Greek word for love is agape. Brother Ray's been talking a lot about this lately. It means affection. It means darling. Have you ever had someone come up and say, darling, how are you doing? Amen. Oh, my. Amen. Don't you love it when someone calls you darling? Hello, amen, or open. Don't you love it when someone says, how are you? I just love you so much. I just appreciate you so very much. Don't you love it when someone just goes out of their way and just shares their love for you and just tells you about all this love that they have for you? This is what we call agape love. Amen. It means affection. It means darling. It means loving and fondness. The Hebrew word, believe it or not, is ahava. It's often used to refer to the love between two people, but can also be used to refer to love for God, family, and friends, and humanity in general. Both are Old Testament and New Testament meanings. Agape, ahava, which means love, brotherly love, sisterly love. You know what? This church would grow if we love it more. Can you say amen? Why? Because love is contagious. Love catches on, amen? When people know you love them, they like to hang around you. Some say amen or oh, damn. I don't know about you, but I don't want to hang around with somebody that don't like me very much. How about you? This is the feeling I get. I want to hang around people that like me, that show appreciation. Amen. Even though they see my flaws, they don't have to point them out. What do you say? Because I already know I got them. How many got a whole bunch of flaws in your life? Amen. We all do. We're all imperfected. None of us are perfect. Someone say amen. Or me. The only one that's perfect died on the cross. Amen. He died. But guess what? You and me, we have technical problems with us. Some of us, amen, we got issues that just surround us and encapsulate us. But I want you to know, it doesn't mean we're bad people. It just means that we're not perfect. God is still working on me. Can you say amen? He's still working on me. Amen. He made me the way I ought to be. And this is the way I look at it. Amen. So I want to share to you this agape love. You and I need to have it more illustrated in our life. You and I need to share this love with one another. Encourage one another. Be there for one another. Amen. Lift each other up in prayer. Can you say amen? For one another. Amen. Salute one another with love and kindness and joy. Because this is what God wants us to be. He wants us to be Christians. Can you say amen? He wants us to act like Christians. He wants us to love like Christians. But he doesn't want us to be a mean Christian. He doesn't want you to be a mean. I don't know about you, but we don't need to be mean. We need to be kind. Can you say amen? And loving. Amen. And merciful. Amen. You see someone in need, reach out and help them instead of picking on them and tearing them up and say, well, you're just nothing but a bum. Well, we know that. How many understand that? They already know they're a bum. Amen. Why? They can look at themselves and tell they're a bum. Someone say amen or amen. But they don't need someone to pronounce judgment over them and say, you're worthless. You're no good. That's not what they need in their life. What they need is someone to say, hey, I've been there where you're at. And I want you to know, God helped me. He helped me through it. Amen. He picked me up. He loved me again. He showed love and consideration towards me. Amen. I don't know about you, but I would never came to church if someone hadn't loved me and brought me to church. Someone say amen or amen. If it hadn't been for that sister coming out and getting me, every time I'd see her coming, I'd take off running because I don't have to go to church. Oh, thank God for that precious woman. She's gone to be with the Lord, but her reward is great. Her glory. she didn't know. She didn't have a clue what was going on. She didn't know that God was calling me to be a preacher of the gospel and all these other things that go with it. Amen. I can't tell you how many people have been touched by God. I'll never know until that day of judgment comes. But I do know this, if she hadn't came and got me, if she wasn't loving and kind and considerate and showed some type of compassion to me, I would have never became a Christian. I would have never been born again. I would have never gave my heart to God. And she kept coming after me. Don't give up on your family. Keep after them. Keep going after them. So, are you coming to church today with me? Now, they might hide and run when you drive up in their parking lot, but guess what? Amen. Look, this is proof right here. Come on. Sometimes I'd be out running around, and I was only 14 years old then. And all of a sudden, she'd play a sneaky on me. And how many know what sneaky is? Well, her husband dropped her off, and I'd run into the house and ready to eat whatever mom had left over to eat because I was starving to death. How many know what I'm talking about? And there she is. I said, oh, my God, there's my sister Doris again. I can't get away from her. She's going to be asking me to go to church again. I know she is. I know she's going to ask me. There's nothing I can do about it. I can't run and hide because if I do that, she knows I'd be what? Avoiding her. And she's my sister, and I didn't want to be disrespectful. And so anyway, I'd go in there and say, "How are you doing, sister?" And she said, "Hon, I am doing so good because I can see you again." And I said, "Oh no. Here it goes. She's going to ask me to go to church with her. Here it goes." She said, "Would you like to go to church?" Yeah. And I said, "No, I don't want to go. I really don't want to go to church. That's not for me. I'm not a church going type person. I don't like it. You know, oh, hon, please go with me. I'll buy you a hamburger." What? No. I'll give you a fry with that and a milkshake. Yeah, let's go. Remember, he that winneth souls is what? Wise? Yeah, whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. My dad always said, my wife said to a man's heart, you got to get his stomach first.
What a man's heart is their stomach.
That Greek word, love, is agape. It means affection. It means darling. Oh, darling. Love. Loving. Fondness. The Hebrew word for love is also ahava. It's used to refer love between two people. Ahava. My wife. You understand? I love her. Ahava. I agape. My brother Jeff. My sister Karen. My brother. My other sister Bobby. My sister Connie. I agape. Now, that's the love for all of you. As I continue here, the agape love, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. John 3:16, the English version, standard version of the Bible. God so loved the world, he adopted it. He adopted the world. imagine if Jesus failed? Which is totally impossible. But what happened if he did? That would have destroyed God's heart. It would destroy him. And what I mean by that, I can't fathom what it would have done to him. I know what it would have done to me. If I had a son that broke my heart. Thank God Jesus did not fail. Can you say amen? Thank God, which is impossible for him to fail. I'm just thinking here. As we continue, God, he speaks out of the most powerful, noblest type of love, sacrificial love. Agape love is more than a feeling. It is an act of the will. This is the love that God has for his people. And that prompted sacrifice of his only son, Jesus, for our sins. Jesus loved agape love. Personified. Start loving people the same way we love God. You're going to see a huge difference right here.
Yeah.
A huge difference.
Amen.
A huge difference. Amen. Let's continue. Number three, God's love is a what? Source of comfort. Our love for one another is a source of comfort. Just as God's is, so is ours. Actions speak louder than words. There are people today who talk about love, but their heart is not really in it. We talk about it. We see what's going on in the world. We don't want to do anything about it. We got to become what? Not only hearers of the word.
Doers.
But we got to become doers of the word.
Yes.
Am I telling the truth here?
Amen.
We got to become doers. Doers is so important. The Apostle Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. He said, follow Christ, otherwise, what he said. I don't know about you, but mimic what other people are doing in the Lord, for the Lord, and for each other. Yeah, Jesus said it. He said, you always will have the poor with you. But he said, I will not always be with you. He told his disciples. We're always going to have the poor. But can we help make their life a little bit different? A little bit better. I think we can. Actions speak louder than words. There's a lot of people talk about love, but their heart is really not in it. 1 John chapter 4, verse 11, beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to what? Love one another. He said here, 1 John chapter 4, no man has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwelleth in us. And his love is perfected in us. His love becomes perfected because why? Is that his love dwelleth in us. How do I know my love becomes perfect? It's because I love you. Do you see what I'm saying? Unconditionally. You could be a millionaire and be the poorest person in this church, and you still have the same gratitude for me.
Amen.
Do you understand? It will still be the same love. When it comes down to it, all we got is each other. When it comes down to the nutshell, the only thing we have that's keeping us all together is each other. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
And that's why it's so important that you love each other. I know you've probably heard 100 messages on love. But for some reason, God wanted me to share this to you today. He said, if you really love me, then show it to each other. Praise the Lord. And I know you love me. I can see it. I hope you can see the love I have for you. My goodness. I wish I had the money to take every one of you to Hawaii. If somebody was to win a lottery and give me some of it, I'd do it. I'd take everyone here. I'd take this whole church to Hawaii. I really would. But guess what?
I want to go to Florida.
I want to live. I don't live in a Peyton Place world. How about you?
Amen.
Or the days of our lives world. This is reality. But I want you to know I love you no matter what. Whether you're poor or wealthy, whether you're young or old, hello? It doesn't matter. Because I love you. Can you say amen?
Amen.
We love you, Pastor. I love you too, Sister Sid. Glad to see you here. I'm so glad you found the keys.
Me too. Actually, I didn't. It's my husband's spare key.
Well, I'm glad you found. She lost her keys.
Oh,
and
dear.
Made it to the church earlier. And now she found them. She found her lost coin. Can you say that?
I did.
Her lost coin, the Bible speaks about. So, praise the Lord for that. Amen. Let us continue. You have to continue. I'm so sorry. Cliffhanger. I apologize. Cliffhanger. Getting into it, how about you guys? Mm-hmm. Well, there are other sources of comfort I want to talk to you about next week or the next time. Mother's Day is next week. So, and remember, do something special for your mom, especially if she's alive.
That's right.
Amen. Your mom is still
me too. Me too.
Still alive. You do something for her. And if your mom is not, do something special for your mom. Or your older sister. Amen. I'll put an older sister. There we go. I'm looking out for you. Do something special. Now, Sister Prince got something I'll plan next Sunday. All you guys make it back. Make it back. Bless her heart. She puts a lot into this. She's not in here right now. She's kind of slipped out for a second, so I can tell you. She puts a lot into this. She really does. She pours her heart into it. So you ladies, show up if you can. It would bless her heart. I want you to know that. It would make her feel so good. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
And meanwhile, I'm going to ask you to pray with me. Father,
yes.
As we come to you, we just pray, Lord, that you have a hand upon each and every person. That God, that you touch each and every heart. Thank you for allowing us to come together and be together. you so very, very much. Appreciate what the Lord is doing in our lives. Father, I thank you again for walking with us, dwelling with us, showing us the scriptures, revealing your love to us through your Son, Jesus Christ, through and by your Holy Spirit. We glorify you, Father. We glorify you because we know that thou art the Lord God Almighty, and we praise thee and glorify thee. And we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Savior, who died on the cross, gave his life for us. We praise God for that. Thank you, Lord God, and thank you, our Lord and Savior. Oh God, bless each and every heart. Touch each and every heart today. Touch their lives, oh God, as they slip their hands and say, oh God, touch me. Is there a person like that? Just slip their hand. God, touch me today. Help me. Is there a person like that? Help me today, God. Just look in here and say, remember me, Lord. Remember me in prayer. Is there a person like that? You like God to remember you in prayer. I see one hand. Is there another? Is another hand? Another one. Anyone else right here? Another. Yes, amen. Oh, God, you saw the hands that raised up.
Yeah.
Remember them in prayer, Lord. Remember them in prayer as I praise the Lord and glorify them. You, Lord, and lift them up. Oh, God, that we just praise you.
Yes, Lord.
That we glorify you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I encourage these brothers and sisters. I encourage them. Lift them up, God, as they glorify you. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Worthy is the Lord. Father, you saw all these hands. You saw their needs, their desires, God. You saw everything they need in their life, God. Help them, God. Help them and hear their prayers. Help them and hear their prayers today. I pray to you in Jesus' wonderful name again. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So glad you came to church today. Would you stand with me as we prepare for ourselves to go home? Remember to love one another. Love one another. I want you to look at the person next to you and say, I love you.
I don't have nobody.
I love you, sister.
I love you. I love you.
Sister Pam, I love you.
Brother
John, I love you. Love you too. He then loves you, sister. So precious.
I love you.
Let us pray as we discuss.
Father,
take us to our separate places. Bring us back to the appointed time as we depart from this place, but not from thy presence. Oh God, have your hand upon us. Be with us and guide us and keep us safe again, yes. Father. Keep us safe until we meet again. In the name of Jesus.